Can you hear the alarm of heaven ringing? The great alarm. These are the days of love arising in a new way. And it will only bring forth new hopes. And so I welcome you. Love from love, hope from hope, peace from peace. And know that these are the days where love is beckoning all of us, our Lord God, that is his name, 1 John 4:7. Those who love are born of him and know him because he is love. So light a new candle of hope for the kingdom age, and know that it will come as it is foretold, and that many things that you have expected will not come, many of the worst things, because it is written in the latter days that God would say, I will return my terrifying anger and stop the craziness. It is written in Jeremiah 30:24, it shall be considered in the latter days that the worst of prophecy can be cut short, just as Jesus said in Matthew 24:22, unless these days were cut short, no flesh could survive. And the only way the time could be cut short is God's word anew, opening again. Nothing else short of that could cut time short, people. And this was foretold in Daniel 12:9, that his word would open at the time of the end. It was only closed till the time of the end, because the message that would prepare his way, Malachi 3:1, had to open anew with his message sent to his latter-day messenger of Malachi 3:1, who would prepare the Lord's way with his own message. And that is why he is saying, I will be your God, you will be my people, I will forgive your iniquity, I will never remember it. I will write my law and my love upon your hearts. Beyond that, no one else shall ever need to be taught of me, says the Lord. For all people of love shall know me, from the least to the greatest, all shall know me, if you keep your love light on. And it's time to do that. And it's time to realize that there are things happening on this planet Earth that people have been oblivious to. One is that I am the viceroy of Pope Francis in these latter days of the latter-day Daniel, who I am of Daniel 12:13, who has embraced his destiny as Elijah, the one who restores all things by the covenant. And the Mormons saw it, right, that it's the covenant of God of Jeremiah 31 that will restore all things and turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and children to the fathers. So this earth will not be hurt by the curse that is fully conditional, just as Nineveh was never destroyed in Jonah 3. So these are the days to keep that candle of hope alive, and it will burn off cataracts in our eyes that will stop us from being rooked into believing that prophecy must happen. No, it does not. Prophecy's only been told to change the future, not to tell the future. The Lord wants all the curses of mankind to be lifted if we will stir up our love. Because in these days of Elijah, the curtain has been pulled so that we can see there has never been any love that is love if it is conditional love. There is no such thing. It does not even exist. Love is never conditional. Love only desires to give more of itself away. Love only irresistibly desires that we irresistibly desire him. And he is Lord who changes not. And so know that in these days of the Abrahamic Accord that has been signed, international law all over this world is readying itself to cut off the war from happening so that peace could be established by the will of our Creator God. Therefore, absolutely all religions, and I'm speaking to all people of all religion or none, I am Elijah and I have the scepter of all authority. Everyone on the planet must now unite under one God as one Lord of love, and only then could he possibly bring forth abundant peace unto all generations that we need so desperately in this world. So the people need to be pledged in the sight of God to his love and to all people of the world, and so that the peace advocate, who is Emmanuel, our Lord of love, returning to us, we can all become subject and be people of submission unto his will of love for all people of earth. A greater degree of love than mankind has ever displayed before is what is going to turn this world around by the living waters of the seas of his benevolence, which are moving as great and mighty force of magnificence of his beneficence that's coming forth as rapids of his very best wishes and good tidings to all mankind. And so under his love will come forth the unity of the brotherhood of love to replace all broken religion in this world. And people can collectively come to see that all people of all the world's religions or none must all be recreated through the word of love's seed. These are the days when the wheat and tares cannot grow together. Love, people of love, will come with me, and the rest will stay where they are until they too have a change of heart and become wheat instead of just tares and weeds of hatefulness, and carrying forth the subtle seeds of spiritual racism, and having condemnation in your mouth for one another, and judgmentalism, and nothing but having your fingers pointed. That is why there's 300,000 people dying yearly, Christians, because they're pointing at people. It's time to stop pointing at anyone in these days of the kingdom age being revealed. And in order to be recognized as being part of the family of God, we must all love one another and respect one another. Respect is huge, and the absence of it is even huger. It's by actions that we see how people really feel about us. And so the oneness of love will come, and it's shining a glorious eternal light upon the earth right now, so that we can all love our neighbors as ourselves when we realize the truest truth that we're all angels or demons on the flesh. Just as Jesus said in John 10, we are gods, and the glory of his latter house is greater than that of the former, and the first are last, the last are first. That is why we were created fearfully and wonderfully, higher than the angels. That's why Satan hated us. But praise God, free at last will we be, and all of creation has been groaning with great expectation for the revelation of who we are that has been hidden from us. And now that we know who we are, we may shine as the stars, as Daniel 12 says, for that is what the angels have always been called, the stars of God, and we are just another variety. And that's why Jesus said that we are as gods. That's why the word of God says we will not judge the fallen. We will judge the fallen angels, not God, because we are of the same tribe. And that's why God judges us not. That's why he says, I will be your God. You will be my people. I will forgive your iniquity and never remember it. That's why Satan had to be removed for 1,000 years in accordance with Daniel 12:1, because as the accuser of the brethren, day and night, Satan has been telling God all of our sins, but God could not hear any more of our sins at all, or else he would be a liar by his own word of Jeremiah. And Jeremiah is the only kingdom age prophet that has ever been necessary in accordance with Daniel, the book of Daniel, and Jeremiah 1:10 and Haggai 2:2. Jesus Christ is the carpenter of the ages, and for his restoration of Acts 3:21, the hammer of his mouth, the tongue, the rod of his tongue, It comes down as the hammer of God to tear down all kingdoms of man's imagination, not built solely on his unconditional love, just as Jeremiah 1:10, his appointment was. For Christ is appearing now and revealing that he has truly been the sower of the seed of love who has overtaken his reaper. And these are the days that people need to recognize the need for everyone's repentance of lovelessness. And that is the chief sin of all sins. And inaction is next to that. To see good and not to do good is one of the worst sins on this planet. But praise God, Jesus says all sin will be forgiven. Absolutely all sin, even sin against him. Just not unforgivable sin if we let the light, his light of love in us, go out. Look into your eyes and ask yourself, talk to the man or woman in the mirror. Do you see love looking back at you? If not, it's time to repent and move that love back to where it should be, alive and vibrant, moving forward as a little child. But don't be too hard on yourself. You know, light the candle of truth, that if you're going two steps forward and one step back even, you're still going in the right direction. Sometimes we got to fake it till we make it and start with baby steps. So it's time for all followers of love will come forth in his glory. And these will be people from every tribe, every nation, every tongue, every belief or every non-belief. For he is love living in us. So stir it up unto overflowing. And know that through his grace, humanity will now be led into salvation, which is already our inheritance. And we can move away from death only now that we have our foundations clear and we understand the truest truths that have always been absolute over one and all of us. So we all need to acknowledge that unity among all people is always found along the common path of people praying and caring for one another. And it's now more clear than ever before that all past division of people from one another has been chiefly the work of the father of lies and the lover of discord, and that was not God. It served his purposes to let the people be divided. And he saw that if we stood together, he said at Babel, that there's nothing that can be kept from us, that absolutely nothing we could imagine, we could achieve absolutely anything, because he is our overcomer of overcomers, and he is the victory in all who are victorious. And in spite of our differences, all those readying their hearts for the world, they will see that we are one race and one family, born of one God of love, who loves everybody absolutely equally without any repentance or apologies for that truth at all. For all of religion, for the most part, has only been a vain attempt at getting God to love these ones more than those ones, to make God into a respecter of men. And he's never wanted to have any part of that because he is love. So let the wise now understand why it's better for them to be the least among